Gardevoir was just released in Pokemon Unite, and her kit is loaded with damage, cooldown resets, and other mechanics that make her a bit complicated to play with or against. If you want to learn how to deal as much damage as possible with this new mage-like character, or how to avoid taking all that damage when you're playing against her, then you're watching the right video. Hey, I'm Yoko Bajo, and I stream Pokemon Unite over on Twitch. I just played a ton of Gardevoir games, and now I'm ready to share what item build and move sets I recommend, as well as just explain everything about how she works. That way, you'll know what's going on and how to counter her when she's in one of your games. I think this Pokemon has a much weaker early game than other attackers currently in the game, but her mid-game power spike is extremely potent, and in the late game, she can become a monster when played correctly. Let's start with Gardevoir's basic attacks. As you should know from watching my guide on special attack damage versus physical damage, all basic attacks in Pokemon Unite will deal physical damage. Gardevoir is a special damage focused Pokemon, so her third attack will deal special damage. That boosted third auto will deal damage in a small area of effect and reduce the special defense of enemies caught in the blast. Gardevoir's passive ability Synchronize will reflect any slow or damage over time effect applied to Gardevoir back onto her enemy. Gardevoir will still become affected by the slow or damage over time, but so will her opponent. This ability will go on cooldown once it is triggered, so if you would like to counter it, then try using an ability that will apply a damage over time effect to trigger the cooldown and then use your slows to lock her down. Gardevoir is an extremely slow Pokemon, so once you've applied a slow to her, she becomes a sitting duck. But if you allow her to slow you back with her Synchronized passive, then it becomes an even trade, basically making it like she didn't even get slowed. Gardevoir's basic moves are Confusion and Teleport. Confusion will fire a projectile that deals special damage to everything in a straight line. This isn't the fastest moving projectile, so you will have to lead your shots on moving targets. Teleport is a pretty basic repositioning tool that allows you to teleport a short distance while simultaneously loading up your third auto attack. You should probably always start with Confusion, because that's the move which will actually deal damage and help you knock out your A-palms faster on your way to lane. It's up to you to decide if you want to use Teleport offensively to push forward towards your opponent with a boosted attack at the ready, or save it to get yourself out of trouble. When you know you're safe and not in danger of getting knocked out, then I say go ahead and use it to speed up your wild Pokemon knockouts or to pressure out your opponents. But if you know a gank from the enemy jungler could be coming, or your opponents have enough firepower to punish you for wasting your escape tool, then just make sure you hold on to it. At level 6, you will get the option to change Teleport into Psyshock or Future Sight. Both of these moves have long range, decent sized AoEs, and deal a truckload of damage. No matter which move you pick, getting your level 6 will be a huge power spike that allows you to apply a lot of pressure from a very safe distance. Future Sight allows you to set off a delayed explosion that deals about as much damage as one of Gengar's Sludge Bomb Hex combos. Landing the Future Sight hit will reduce its cooldown by 1 second, and at level 11 it will be upgraded so that landing the hit will completely reset that cooldown. The cooldown will not be reduced when you hit wild Pokemon. Your other move choice is Psyshock. This move deals 3 bursts of AoE damage as opposed to Future Sight's single burst of damage. Landing 2 of the hits will get about as much damage as a single Future Sight, and landing all 3 hits will be more damage than Future Sight. Every time one of the Psyshock hits lands on an opposing Pokemon, the cooldown will be reduced by 1 second. At level 11, Psyshock will be upgraded so that every time Psyshock hits something, the damage of the next Psyshock hit will become even stronger. Using Psyshock will take a bit of getting used to. The way it works is once you choose a location for the first Psyshock, the next two hits will target the same spot relative to where Gardevoir is standing. So, if Gardevoir moves forward, the next Psyshock hit moves forward too. If Gardevoir moves back, the next hit will move back with her. After using Psyshock on an opponent, watch them closely and mirror whatever move they make to maintain the same relative position. This will allow you to land as many of the three hits as possible. Be aware of your surroundings when you do this. If mirroring your target's movements means running face first into danger, then you may just want to back off and let the next two hits miss. When Gardevoir uses either her Psyshock or Future Sight on you, that's your cue to use whatever movement tool you have available to either get away from the AoE or get closer to Gardevoir and knock her out before the next round of damage comes. Psyshock is a great move for dealing as much damage as possible to your opponents and wild Pokemon. Future Sight is one of the best single bursts of damage in the game, allowing you to deal with highly mobile characters like Gengar or Cinderace who might otherwise be able to dodge a lot of Psyshock's damage. At level 8, Confusion can be upgraded into either Psychic or Moonblast. Both moves fire projectiles that deal damage on impact and apply a bit of crowd control. Psychic will deal damage over time in a small area of effect, either at the end of the projectile's range or at the location of the first target hit. Enemies inside the AoE will be slowed. At level 13, this move's cooldown is reduced by 3 seconds. Moonblast's projectiles will push Gardevoir herself slightly backwards, stun the first target it hits, and deal a single burst of AoE damage in a cone behind that target. At level 13, this move's upgrade will give Gardevoir a small shield each time the move is used. If you aren't worried about a very mobile enemy, then I think Psychic is the way to go. It will deal more damage than Moonblast and leave your opponents crowd-controlled for longer if they can't escape that AoE. If you do need to worry about a speedster that can just jump right on top of you, then Moonblast will allow you to hard stun them and deal as much damage as possible while they are stuck. Gardevoir's Unite move is called Fairy Singularity. This move is one heck of a teamfighting tool. It will drop a black hole that pulls enemy Pokemon into the center before dealing a burst of damage and shoving enemy Pokemon away from the blast. If you find yourself getting pulled into the center of Gardevoir's Fairy Singularity, then do anything to get yourself out. If you're a Pikachu and your only way of getting out would be to Volt Tackle into 4 enemies, then Volt Tackle into 4 enemies, baby. Do anything to not be in that black hole anymore, because every single enemy cooldown is about to get dropped into that black hole's AoE. For Gardevoir, this move is your big combo starter. Start with your black hole, then use either your Psyshock or Future Sight, and finish with your Moonblast or Psychic to keep them crowd controlled. If you've already lost the element of surprise, then I recommend baiting out your opponent's escape tools with any of your other moves before you pop your Fairy Singularity. Once you see that your key target has used their escape tool, then get in there and go for your full Unite move combo. All of Gardevoir's moves are very good, so deciding which moveset to use will be situational. When I'm laning against a less mobile set of opponents, then I like to take Psyshock at level 6 so that I can have access to as much damage as possible. When I'm facing enemies who could easily jump right on top of me, then I'd rather go for Future Sight to deal single bursts of damage when I can catch them while their movement abilities are on cooldown. If you go Future Sight, then I think you should always take Moonblast at level 8. Moonblast's stun will allow you to guarantee that Future Sight lands and run away so that you don't get immediately pounced on. If you go for Psyshock, then Psychic will give you an extremely powerful combo for dealing insane damage to opponents in an area of effect. Sometimes I take Moonblast instead of Psychic along with Psyshock if my lane doesn't contain any super mobile opponents, but I am still worried about a speedster that's getting out of hand. Once you hit level 6, start spamming the crap out of whatever move you chose. Both Psyshock and Future Sight deal tons of damage from really far away, so you can steal wild Pokemon KOs and punish your opponents for standing anywhere near you while not paying attention. Use this pressure to dominate your lane while maintaining awareness of when that enemy jungler is coming for you so that you can back out before they get a chance to sneak up on you. Be sure to check out my Twitch stream, link in the description, if you want to learn more about Gardevoir's playstyle and how best to take advantage of everything in her kit. I really enjoyed playing her, and I think she's definitely going to become one of my mains. So don't be shy, come by, and say hi. You know you don't want to miss any of my epic black hole plays. I definitely think that Gardevoir benefits a lot from laning with a tanky defender who can keep the enemies busy while Gardevoir nukes them from the back line. In a lot of my games, I was laning with my buddy Wave on Cinderace. I don't necessarily recommend this lane combo. It's just something we decided to do because neither of us felt like playing a tank. We weren't really able to score very many kills and mostly had to play safe until our jungler came by. Our plan was just to sit in lane, get levels, and use our high damage to take Rotom whenever we saw the enemy jungler was busy somewhere else. Again, I don't recommend this kind of lane setup. Having a defender in lane with Gardevoir would make it way more possible to actually get enemy KOs and score goals, and overall just apply more pressure on the map by forcing the enemy jungler to come worry about this lane. For items, I recommend taking Wise Glasses and special attack specs for sure. For the last slot, I recommend Shell Bell for more early game strength or Energy Amplifier for better late game Unite move combos. Alternatively, you could throw in a Score Shield to help with scoring, or Float Stone to increase her very low move speed. I don't really like Score Shield or Float Stone for Gardevoir personally because her mobility is so low that Float Stone isn't really going to do enough to change that. And while Score Shield does allow you to score while under pressure, Gardevoir's low mobility makes her really bad at dealing with pressure, so I think it's best to just not even try to score risky goals unless you have your team close by to get you out of trouble. Okay, actually, I just figured out that Gardevoir's move speed is actually completely average. I don't know why I felt like she was moving really slow, but I still think it's true that she really lacks mobility because after level 6, she doesn't have teleport and completely lacks an escape tool. For your battle item, I would go for Eject Button or X Speed. Both of these tools can be used in emergencies to help Gardevoir escape danger despite her extreme lack of mobility. If you are really confident in your positioning and your team's ability to peel for you when you get flanked, then you could go for Goal Getter instead to let you score your big goals faster and then back away from the enemy goals sooner. If you're like me, then you're probably wondering if Gardevoir is a good jungler. She's not. I know this won't stop people from trying it, but let me lay it out for you. Her low move speed and lack of crowd control until level 8 make her ganks really weak, so it's similar to having a Garchomp jungle. Basically, you're not able to give your team any good ganks until it's already too late. I know it's tempting to try to force Gardevoir to work in the jungle so that you can get more EXP and hit your power spikes sooner, but trust me, it's not worth it to sacrifice your team just so that one Pokemon can get stronger. Just play Gardevoir in the lane. You'll get level 6 eventually, and when you do, you'll be able to take over your lane. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you learned something from today's video so that you can see my future Pokemon Unite content. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye! Another all-nighter to get a video out as soon as possible. But the people gotta know what's going on with Gardevoir. Kind of screwing myself over because I want to play Gardevoir. I don't even get to have one day of fun where people don't know what she does because I'm telling everyone what she does and how to counter her. I don't know. It's what I like to do, so I did it. All right, thanks guys. Bye.